In this video, I'll explain you how to know if you're insulin resistant or not. I'll show you a simple insulin resistance test that you can do at home. It's really easy and it gives you pretty accurate results. So if you want to learn more about insulin resistance blood test and how to interpret your insulin blood test results, check out my other video about it. It should appear on the screen right now. In this video, I will talk about insulin resistance test that you can do at home. By the way, if you're new to my YouTube channel, my name is Greta and I'm an online nutritionist and a holistic health coach. If you haven't yet, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. So first, why would you want to know if you have insulin resistance? Insulin resistance is more common than you may think. Around 90% of people are insulin resistant and most cases are undiagnosed. Most likely, if you are watching this video, you are insulin resistant. And so many people might be tricked thinking that if they are not overweight, they are healthy. That's not the case. You can be skinny and be insulin resistant. I will show you a simple insulin resistance test at home that you can do right now. All you need is a measuring tape. The number that we will be looking at is called the waist to height ratio. You will have to measure your waist circumference first. To measure waist circumference, stand up and place a tape measure around your waist, just above your hip bones, slightly below your ribs. It should be close to your belly button. Without pressing too much, measure your waist after you breathe out. You might be thinking, why is this ratio important and how can your waist show if you're insulin resistant or not? Well, abdominal fat is a good indicator of insulin resistance because excess insulin makes you store fat around your midsection. So now as you know your waist circumference, how can you calculate your waist to height ratio? The waist height ratio is calculated as waist measurement divided by height measurement in centimeters. For example, if your waist is 80 centimeters and your height is 175 centimeters, you would have a waist height ratio of 0.46 that is considered insulin sensitive. And someone with a 100 centimeter waist and 160 centimeter height would have a waist to height ratio of 0.63 that is considered significant insulin resistance. I will leave the link in the description to an online waist to height ratio calculator where you can enter your details and see the results. How to interpret your waist to height ratio results? Less than 0.53 means that you're insulin sensitive. 0.53 to 0.58 means that you have some insulin resistance. And more than 0.58 indicates that you have significant insulin resistance. Now, what can you do if your results show that you are insulin resistant? Well, first, don't panic. There's a lot you can do to reverse insulin resistance. This was a simple way you can test your insulin resistance at home, but you can also see your doctor and ask for a homa-ir insulin resistance test to confirm that you are actually insulin resistant. So first, I would highly suggest you to learn more about insulin resistance. I have another video with a simple explanation of what is insulin resistance. It's called Insulin Resistance, the Silent Killer. And then after, you should watch my other video explaining how to reverse insulin resistance. You can implement simple changes into your lifestyle today that will make a huge difference in your insulin resistance. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.